see what it is. Okay. So just the really relevant point to this is a couple of things I wanted to call out and the questions that we've had over the last, and again, it is only 2 weeks since we've launched this. But how will this impact the quality score? What are the kind of possibilities there? What counts as an ad impression in the new user interface? And longer term, what's going to happen to click-through rates or traffic, query volume, query mix? Two of these questions I can answer right now for you. The last will take a little bit of time because we have some data. So one of the ones we can answer right now is what counts as an impression? So again, if you look at this pretty useful screenshot here, there are a couple of ways. Very simply, if you start typing, as before, if you press enter when you finish your query, and press enter, that maps an impression to the ad. That's exactly the same as it was before. If you start entering your query, and you choose one of the drop-down autocomplete suggestions, again, that maps an impression, which is the same as it was before. Clicking search, exactly the same as it was before. There are a couple of little differences here, though, as well, that in the new interface, if you start typing, and you click on one of the natural results, or click on one of the tool options on the left-hand side, that's going to map an impression as well, then you add a page at that time. And the really interesting one is the one, the 3 second rule or 3 second pause here. So this is kind of the more interesting one. So this is essentially saying, as the name suggests, if you start typing and you look at the window or you're distracted by something shiny, and wait 3 seconds, at that point we'll actually map an impression then. So if you then continue to type, then search again, that will actually be 2 impressions that you have given to the user. So this is one of the ones that are kind of adding some interest to the whole thing. And people are asking how will this, you know, affect the impression count and how will this affect the quality score, all those kind of things. The 3 second rule is something that we in experiments kind of found to be the minimum amount of time that people needed to scan the ad on the page, but it is very much what we find in the coming months, based on more data, that that's too short, too long, we might make adjustments to that. But for now, these are the ways that we map the impression, and they're the only ways we map the impression. So how will that impact quality score? Essentially, so impressions were a big concern, and quality scores was another big concern. And essentially, again, there was no reason to panic about this because the assumption, I guess, on everyone's part is that impressions would increase for a number of advertisers. As users get used to actually how the interface works, by virtue of the 3 second rule, by virtue of multiple more ways to actually map an impression. So people were saying if I get lots of impressions and my clicks are the same, that the quality score is going to go down, but the click-through rate, as I said, which is really important, is going to go down as well. So that, on paper, is true. But what we will do is, in the background, is normalize or equalize that effect. We know if someone is getting impressions based on the new Google Instant interface, and if they're very much inflated, we're going to make adjustments or normalize that fact. So we're still comparing apples to apples, like with like. So we're looking at your performance relative to the other ads or competitors in your own area. So we're not going to see advertisers suddenly drop in the next week or two from 10 out of 10 to 1 out of 10 or 2 out of 10. That's just not going to happen, basically. There may very well be edge cases where something happens that we don't know about, but we will, you know, take that on board and deal with them. But the message is, again, that nothing changed, basically. Nothing's going to change with the way we rank or assign quality scores for advertiser accounts. So if anyone has any questions on this, ask me afterwards if you have any concerns or you have seen any problems. Hopefully it happens, but again, shouldn't happen, shouldn't be an issue. The one question that we can't answer is what would happen to query volumes, query mix in the long term? I guess my answer to you or my question to that question would be, if you could tell me how all advertisers will suddenly start using this, will they opt out, which is an option? Will they all adopt this and understand it off the bat? If you can tell me exactly how user behavior will work, it's a lot easier to explain how the query mix will change. If you look at the Google Suggest autocomplete, what happened when we launched that? There was a slight move towards head terms, which are the kind of shorter number of words in the keywords, so 1, 2, 3 kind of keywords. There was a slight shift towards that because of Google Suggest and that introduction. It's likely that we'll see something of similar nature with the introduction of Google Instant. But again, we're not killing the long tails. There's probably more opportunity. We're surfacing a lot more long tail keywords at the same time. So for search engine optimizers, for marketers that optimize average accounts, there's plenty of opportunity there as well. But again, only time will tell, and given that we only have 2 weeks data, and it's only available for signed in users, by the way, as well at the moment, so that's only about 10% of the UK market, we won't know until we launch this more fully, have more data to work with, and we'll very definitely be rolling out best practices.